Today, I'm gonna also show you the tools on how you can draw trend line. So let's dive into the system and the terminal, and let's see what tools you can use to draw a trend line. All right, this is the chart. This is a Euro USD chart on H1 time frame. Now, if you want to draw a trend line, you have to hover over, take your mouse to this tool here, as you can see that. If your own is not appearing here, right click on the chart, click customize. You can drag anything you want to drag in and insert it to this tool. For example, if I want to insert this triangle here, I click here and click insert. It's going to appear here, guys. You see that? So if I want to remove it, I have to click and click remove. It will disappear here. So if your tools is not showing up, just right click here and click customize and insert any trending tools you want to insert, Fibonacci, triangle, expansion, or etc. So if you want to draw a trend line, you come to this draw trend line, click on it. Now, as I told you guys in my former video, you need to target a swing high or a swing low. For example, let's draw a trend line of a swing. Let's draw a trend line, guys, before I move into how to draw a bullish trend line or bearish trend line. That this will be in another video, but I want to show you guys on how to do that. You pick up a swing high here and target a swing high here too. So this, look at these two swing high here, right? Now we have a ray. These things we call it a ray. So in order for us to adjust this long movement you see here, you have to double click on this, double tap on this. You have three nodes here. Now when you double click, right click on it, make sure your mouse in it, right click on it and click on what? Properties. Now you can be able to do what? Go to parameters and remove the ray. Click on remove the ray. You can, from here, come on, you can also change the color, adjust the settings, and put a description. So guys, so you can even adjust the width or the thickness of the trend line, or you can also make it thin or so. So if I choose this light thick line, I can be able to select this one. But if I choose a thick one, this one is locked automatically. So I can change the color of the trend line. If I want it to be green or yellow, let me choose yellow. And I have to click that. I have unchecked this ray, which I showed you guys that this long movement here is ray. I have unchecked it and I have to click OK. Now the whole thing has turned yellow. Now, if I want to draw a trend line, I have to pick up the node, place the trend line on the one hand, then take the last node and hover it around and get the last one here, guys. If I want to extend it, I can be able to extend it, guys. If I want to pick it down, I can be able to adjust it in any way. So when I pick it, when I take this node to this area, I can be able to double click and it's locked. So I cannot move this here again. So this is how you can take a tool and draw a trend line. And you can also, pull it down to any trend line. If you want to take it off this area and place it in another area, you click in the center node, hold and drag, place it anywhere you want to place it here, and take this first node again and what? Pick up the next swing high of the market. You get it? So this is how you can use a trend line to draw a trend line on your chart. And you can draw a trend line on any time frame, be it 4 hours, daily, weekly, 1 hour. So and another thing also, again, if you want to use a trend line in order to get a market structure, or maybe a market structure in the sense of having a falling wedge, rising wedge, you can also use trend line for that. For example, something like this, something like this. If you have something like this, you know, if you see something like this in the structure, I can be able to adjust it a little and get the lows of this market. Maybe take it here and also capture this one here, and I extend it to this area. So what market does now is it bounces on this what zone. If you can pick this, it bounces on this zone, and what happens next? It took out this zone and calmed down. So this is more like a falling wedge, guys. So we have a rising wedge, falling wedge, edge, W and M patterns. This will be in another lecture altogether. So this is exactly how you can draw a trend line using the trend line tools, guys. All right, thank you and God bless you. The next lecture, I told you guys I'll be taking this thing bit by bit, so it will sink in. I don't want to say have like 6 hours video or 1 hour video saying different thing. It gets boring. So when you get this, it sinks in immediately. So this is the tool you can use to draw a trend line, and you can customize this tool by let me lock this up by double clicking on this. It's locked, so it cannot be moved. Now if I want to set this up or push it out, I have to double click on the line, right click on it, and come to settings, and I'll do what? Adjust the settings. adjust the settings, and any other thing I want to adjust here. All right, thank you guys, and God bless you.